Well, hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft, and welcome to my series Bushcraft from A to Z in random order. And of course, it's in random order because I'm going to make my series not according to the alphabet, but according to what I think is interesting. So during the series, I will cover all the letters in the alphabet, but if I find a subject that I think is interesting, I'll make that before the next letter. So. And to point that out, of course, I'm starting with the letter A. Yeah, and that's because I have planned this for a long time. Actually, some months ago, I asked you subscribers for suggestions about things I could say about the letter A. And one of the suggestions, actually, there was many that was saying that, is about ash. So. This is the first episode, and it will be about ash, the letter A. So hang on. And when I say ash, I also mean a little bit of charcoal, because some of the things I found out includes that you are using charcoal as well. And the first thing I will talk about is the ash that has pest repellent. That means that if you spray it around your campsite, the insects will not come to you. And that's because ash is alkaline, and it actually burns the little creatures, so they won't touch it. And that's a good thing if you're out in the camp. You saw me here, I had ants here. I didn't use ash at that time, but cinnamon and some vinegar, and that's also well too. But ash is a pest repellent, and you can use it also in your house. And you can actually also use ash for brushing your teeth. Yes, that's right. And you even have the opportunity to buy toothpaste with ash or charcoal in. It's amazing. And the reason why ash is good for your tooth brushing is because there's something called potassium hydroxide in it. And it's also known as loo. And I'll come into that later. And loo has a tendency to clean your teeth, and it's also antibacterial, so you can use that, but don't overdo it, because in time it could damage your teeth. So only do it when you're on a hike and you forgot your toothpaste paste. And the S is actually also a good smell absorber. It cleans out odor, and you can use it in your latrine, and you're out in your camp or in the woods. And you can use it back home. If there's something smelling in your refrigerator, you can put a little bowl of ash in there, and it will take that smell or odor. And it's because there's carbon in ash, and carbon absorbs a lot of gas particles that is holding the odor or the smell. So use ash if you want to get rid of the smell from your latrine. And because ash is antiseptic, you can also use it to wash your hands. If you come ashes on your hands, fingers, and a little bit of water, then you can wash your hands, and it's almost as good as soap. So if you have forgotten your soap or your hands are very dirty, you can wash your hands in ashes too. That's awesome. And because ash is disinfecting and antiseptic, you can use it on wounds as a first aid kit. So if you have a little scratch, put some ash on it, and wash it away after a few minutes, and your wound will be clean. And I talked about it before, the urchin that was found down in the Alps some years ago, a 1,000-year-old man. He had actually tattoos on his body, and these tattoos was made from ash. They carved a little bit in his skin and put ashes in, and that way in the old days, long before ink and so on, they could use ash for tattoos, to make tattoos. And the Ötzi-man actually had many tattoos on his body. And one of the things I have used ashes for was to make my loo water for the Amadou. I made a video about that, and I'll put a link below so you can see what I'm talking about. But I'll just upzoom it here so you have a little understanding why ashes can be used that way. When you come ashes and a little bit charcoal in water and boil it for a time, and in the ash there is something that is good when you are lighting your Amadou. calcium nitrate and potassium nitrate. KNO3. And actually a thing that is the ingredients in gunpowder. So when you are making your loo and putting the amadou in it, it will actually obtain a little bit of that, and it will be easier for you to lighten your amadou. But I'll put a link below to that video where I show you how to do it. And if you're out in the woods and you need to repair something, you can actually make your glue out of resin and ash. Three parts of resin and one part of ash. You mix it together, warm it up, mix it together, and it's actually a strong glue. In the Stone Age, they used that for the arrowheads on their arrows, and it actually holds quite a lot. And as you saw in my latest video, I actually used ash for making my fire. I used a little bit of ash and a little bit of cotton and rolled it tight together, and then I used two pieces of wood, and the friction when I roll it together created so much heat that the cotton actually got an amber, and that amber I blowed into a little bird's nest and made my fire out of that. But in the Viking Age they didn't have cotton, so today I'll try it with dew twine. Dew twine is something that has been used for many, many years, and I think it could be cool if I could make fire that way. So now when I'm going to make my fire, I'll try it to make my fire with dew twine and ashes. So hang on. Yeah. Now I try to make something similar as I did with the cotton, using dew twine instead. And then I come a little bit of ash on, about a third up. Yeah. And then I roll it tight together. I don't think I need this. And a little bit of ash here should help. Then slowly I'm going to roll it so that the dew twine doesn't split up. Then I take my board here . It's looking good . So now I'm going to do it fast and with a lot of pressure on, so I have to sit up, and then we'll see. It is hot, but I don't think then there's smoke. Yeah, can you see that smoke? And then we take this bird nest, put it in here, there we are. Yeah, and as you saw, I did make fire with ashes and jute twine. So if I'm going to do that again, I'll definitely use my jute twine for that. It's more old school, don't you think? Yeah. No. Now I'm going to prepare a little lunch for myself. A couple of weeks ago, I actually won a giveaway. It was a 100 subscribers giveaway, and the channel name is Back Lakes Bushcraft and Outdoor. It's a guy called Shem, I think it's right pronounced, and I won that giveaway. And the prize was actually this little pan of carbon steel pan, and I'm very pleased with it. Yesterday I seasoned it. That's because yesterday I seasoned it, and that's why it's looking like that now. And now today I'm going to use it for the first time over my fire, and I have planned to make a burger. Well, now it's beginning to rain. Perhaps I have to postpone this a little bit. Yeah, I hope the fire won't die out until then. Yeah, and as I mentioned earlier, I won this in a giveaway from Shem. Of course, I put a link below to his channel. He makes some awesome videos, I can tell you. Let's see. Oh, it's almost too big. But I think it will shrink. And Shem also sent me these, this spice, Montreal steak spice. And I know this is going to be put on a steak, but I can't eat a steak today, so my burger will have to do with this. But I think the taste is great. Yeah, and I don't know if there's salt in this, so to be sure, I put a little bit of salt on. I think it's done. Doesn't it look nice? Well, I should have brought some bacon. That would be that would have been very nice. But lunch is ready.
Skål.
And Shem was so kind to send me not only the pan that I won in his giveaway, but also a lot of other stuff. You saw I have my Montreal steak spices that I've wanted to try for a long time, and it tastes really good even on this burger. So thank you, Shem. And he sent me some tobacco. You know, I'm a pipe smoker. And this tobacco is, I think it's very strong because it's burly. Cavendish. It's Cavendish, and I know that's a strong tobacco. I'm looking forward to taste this. I haven't opened it yet. I'll do that today. And send me some coffee. Look at this. Dead with coffee. They say this is the strongest coffee you can get. And it's beans, so I'm going to grind it in a wild and put it in my coffee today. I'm looking very much forward to try this. Shem says that this tastes delicious, and I'm sure it does. So this is my coffee for today, and of course I have to put some whiskey in. And Shem sent me this Jim Beam whiskey that he likes in his coffee, and of course I try it. It's bourbon, and I like bourbon. So this one, this coffee and whiskey is for you, Shem. I'm looking very much forward to tasting all the things you have sent to me. So thank you very much. Yeah, it's great. And I know you like coffee and whiskey too.
going to put a little bit of salt in it. So, in a short while it will start to boil.
That one is for you, Shem. Thank you very much for all your kindness and support. And now let me taste your coffee and whiskey. It's good coffee and wonderful whiskey. I really like bourbon. Also in my coffee. So now let's taste the tobacco. And look at this, I got a new pipe. It's called a Falcon, and it's actually very cool because you can unscrew the head, and in here you can come a pipe cleaner that will take most of the things that are coming down. And well, this one is cooling the smoke. It's actually an old invention. I read in the 40s, I think, American man who had invented this, and I saw it in the video, and I thought, well, I have to have such a pipe. And this head is Merskum that I bought. It's perfect, and I like the look at it, and it's very light. So this is the pipe, my new pipe I'm going to smoke with your new tobacco. And oh, it's delicious. It's very black tobacco, I know that. I think it's the Cavendish. Let's light it up. Captain Black is the name of this pipe tobacco. Royal, Golden Cavendish, and delightful aromatic. Well, it tastes great, I can say. Skål, Shem, and thank you again. Delightful. This is life. Well, this is all for now, folks. Hope you enjoy my little video and my series Bushcraft for Major Sets. It's been a nice day, sun, shower, coming and going. That's the way the Danish autumn is. Hope you're having a nice day, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.